Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I will show you how to install Conda in a Linux distribution. What I'm going to show you is pretty similar to what you will do in any operating system. There is some changes, but well, I will give you in any case all the documentation later on if you have some specific requirements. Today we will cover not only the installation in a Linux distribution. We will see as well how to install, in this case, Conda. It's the similar process that install a mini Conda, and how later on install a environment. I will give you some tips, how to install, remove packages, etc. And later on, as well, how to remove completely the software case that you need. So today, we will work in a Debian 9 that is running in a Windows System Linux. The host is a Windows 11 64 bytes. So I suppose that you had a similar installation. So the process is going to be exactly the same if you are working with any Linux variants, CentOS, Red Hat. You need the same binary, so you don't need to change anything. In any case, I will give you as well a link to the documentation, Anaconda documentation, and you can check if you had any specific requirements. But I guess that let me check where I have the. Unless that you are working with Power8 or AWS Graviton or ARM system or IBM derivatives like Linux One or H390 or S400, that are mini mainframes, the installation from any Linux derivatives is going to be the same. So it doesn't matter if you are working with Windows System Linux, if you are working with the CentOS, Red Hat, again, Debian, Ubuntu, or others. No? The binary is exactly the same and the process is going to be the same. Okay, I will give you, as I said, all the relevant information. I will post it as usual to the repository. You can check it later on at your convenience in your local environment and replicate what you need. The only requirement, like in this case, is to have a Linux box running. There is no other further requirement, and with this you can start installing the software. So the first thing that we do is install the necessary libraries. Sorry, probably you have it installed on your system, but with this we are going just to ensure that you have it. You need to use sudo to escalate. If you are working in Windows, or you probably need, if you want to install it for all users, you will need to confirm that during the installation process. And if you are working in macOS as well, in Mac OS, you have to provide the password to install for all the users. I already did it, so I had everything installed in my system. Now we need to install a curt or wget, just in case that you don't have it. When I did it first time in this install of Debian in Windows System Linux, curt was not install it, and then so I need to install it, and then you can install it with this command sudo apt-get install curt, and here we are installing both curt and wget. The process to download the binary is exactly the same. Now we go to the repository of Anaconda. Is in this link. I will post you as well in the documentation that I will include later on the description of the video, and then you have here the different versions available. You have a lot. Anaconda is working for a long time. You can see here 2013, 13. Okay, this is irrelevant for us. Yeah, we are going to install the latest. So you have here versions for Windows, MacOS, version x86 architecture or ARM. Also you had Linux x86 64 bytes, all of them are 64 bytes, and S390, this is for mini mainframes. We are not good. And this Arch 64, this is for embedded devices like Raspberry Pi, something like this. We will use this. We are going to install the latest version, and then on this binary, you will use it for any Linux Unix variant, unless again that you are using, for example, Power8 or AWS Graviton or some other derivatives. So we return to the self, and then on we just download the software. Cool. I will patch you as well this this link, and then on you just start to download. This is gonna take a while, so I will stop now, and then on once it's done, I will be back. Well, this is done. We finish the download of the binary. Let's check where we are. Let's L. Okay, we have it here. So now to install the binary, in my case, with a bash shell, I just execute bash that binary. If you are in a CSL or in another environment, just adapt this to the environment where you are working. Okay, now we just start the installation. Well, this is gonna be well, sometimes here is okay. Accept the license terms. You need to choose where to install the software. By default, it's going to be your home directory / Anaconda 3. So if you want to install in another location, it's up to you. I take it by default for the purpose of the video, is I take the default. And now we start the installation. Now I'm unpacking the binary and installing all the libraries on the slash home, in my case, holonog / Anaconda. So it's gonna take a couple of minutes in total. I will start again. Once it's finished, I will be back. Okay, okay, it's done. Now it's continuing with installation, install the base environment, extracting the final packages, and it's gonna take still a couple of seconds after we finish. I'm gonna stop after this is done, and then all we return. Ah no, it's already done. 1 second. Okay, done. Yeah. Now it's asking you if to introduce in the init self init files all the necessary to run the Conda environment. My advice is to do it. The worst case scenario is that you need to revert this. I will show you, I will include as well in the documentation how to do it. In Windows, you can do the same. It's not you have to go to the environment variables and introduce the paths of where you install the software. So to avoid extra work, because here later, for example, in Linux, you have to manually edit some of the files, I recommend you just to do it. In the case that it doesn't work, which is very unlikely, we can revert this situation. So now, depending on the cell that you had, it's touching some different files. In my case, as I had a bash, is touching mainly the .bash.rc file. Now, usually, you need to close the cell and start again, but I will show you now a trick. at least for bash with Discord. This way with source you will reload the environment, and then on now you see here that appears on the left of the prompt base. Now we are with Conda working. Conda is correctly installed. You can execute here Conda and you see that it's working properly. It's not you don't want to do it this way, though you are with some special requirement, you just close the cell and start a new cell again. Now we are going to install a environment. Conda install name of the environment, for example text cp, just hit something Python. Here you specify the version of Python, and you can choose either not to specify the installer or specify PIP. Usually I or my advice is to do it this way, because then you have the choice to use Conda or PIP. If you don't do it, you will have some conflict problems if you later decide to install a package using PIP. So my advice, do it this way, especially if you are working in Unix. Oh, sorry, it's Conda create. Sorry, usually many times I made this mistake. It's Conda create, name of the environment, Python version, and the installer. So now it's gonna take some seconds, especially if you have already some environments or your system. It will just take the Python packages from the cache, and it will take just seconds after it's installed. One note aside is, if you plan to replicate your local environment to other environments, don't miss installation of packages of Conda and PIP. I will explain you now why. Now we activate the environment, and you can check what do you have in your environment with the Conda info. Here is telling you the name, some other useful information, and the path where the environment is. If you check here, you go to Anaconda, you go to EMS, and you can see here, your environment. Okay? Now we return to the home, and to install Python, you can start a Python to check the final version of Python that you install in your environment. In this case, while we specify 3.11, that was here, the final version installed in our environment was 3.58. You just leave the interactive cell. Now we are going to install some packages. Pip install pandas, for example, numpy and scikit learn. You can do it that way, or you can use Python directly, Python minus m. I personally prefer do it this way, and you just with the user at the end, you specify that these packages have to be installed in this user environment. One second, quit. You see here, I make an space here, and then on is entering in an interactive cell again. Okay, we install the packages I install. Now you can install as well on this environment with Conda, but if you mix Conda and PIP, you cannot export later on all the packages with their version to a requirements.txt file to replicate this environment in another system. So you may want to install as well, you can do it, it's no problem, but later on you may have some issues when you try to export the packages. If you want to check which packages you have in your system, you just execute pip list or conda list, which will tell you which packages are installed with conda. So these packages here are the packages that you install when you create the conda environment, and these packages here are the packages that you install with pip. So it's what I tried to tell you before, is if you now install a package with conda, it will come to this list, and then if later you want to export this environment to another machine, well, everything that is not you will be able to export this, and some of this stuff but with some strange links, so it's something that is going to be problematic. My advice is, you install the conda environment, then on, in my advice, install everything, especially if you are working in Unix or Linux variants with PIP. Now, you want to, if you want to, for example, extract all the packages to a requirements file because you want to replicate this environment in another machine, or create, like we are going to do after that, another environment with the same configuration. Let's imagine that you have you install different packages, and then you test your software, and then, well, you want to create finally a version that is going to be working in a Docker or in another machine. What you can do to extract the final versions of your packages after many tests, well, you can use pipfreeze and you redirect the output to a file. Usually the name is requirements.txt. And if you check the requirements.txt, you had all the versions that you had here on the PIP list with the versions, and this file is ready to install another environment. How to do it? Conda deactivate. We leave the environment. We are on the base now. You can do a conda env list to know the how many environments you have. We have here two, base and testcp, and then you create another environment, testcp copy python equal to 311, pip again. I forgot the create. If you choose create, you don't need environment. It's directly with the name, with this parameter, you are specifying that you are going to create an environment. Just yes. And now we will install, we activate the environment, conda create test environment. And now PIP or Python minus n PIP install r file user, and now you are installing all the packages in this environment. If you now execute Python, you will see that you have the same version. You import pandas, for example, and check the version of your package. with panda.dat __, __, __. You can install as well import numpy. And the same numpy dot __, __version, and also install import skylearn. That are the three packages we had before, and you can check skylearn dot __,__version. Okay, here we are. Now, how to delete a Conda environment? First of all, if you want to delete, for example, this copy, you deactivate, you leave the environment, deactivate, sometimes. Sorry. Sometimes I forget. And then now, if you want to delete the environment, Conda remove name of the environment, which is test_cp_copy. And if you specify all, you are going to delete all the packages include that you install in your in that. If you don't specify all, you will only delete the environment from the list of the available environments, but you don't delete the packages from your operating system. Now you just click yes again. Okay, now Conda environment list, the file is not done. And now if you go to CD Anaconda environments, you had still here the TCP, but you don't have the other one anymore. Now, if you want to delete completely Anaconda, the first thing that you need to do is, first of all, deactivate, leave any environment that where you are activated, and execute Conda init reversal. What is doing this command is removing from the cell init files any reference to Anaconda. So we do it here, and then you see here the same that we do in the init, we are doing now a back, no, reversing back. If you want to see the effect of that, you just need to either leave the cell and enter again, or execute the command I showed you before, with this source environment. As you see here, once you enter again, the reference to Conda, Anaconda, disappears. And now you just go to the home and remove the folder with this. Is in my case, in your case, if you install it in another location, you just need to specify the location where you install it. Okay, now we only had the binary and the requirements file, TST file, that we use to create the environment. And that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that you enjoy and you find it interesting and useful for your daily job or for your personal case. And it is a way, I hope that you give me a like for this video and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you very much. See you soon.